Hi, my name is Patrick Reagan. Welcome to the Operating Systems Windows Services, where we discuss the common services provided by Windows, including Active Directory, the managing files and folders, and managing printers. In Part 1, Introduction to Active Directory discusses the Active Directory domain and domain controllers. It then discusses organizational units, user accounts, computer accounts, and groups. It will also show you how to add a computer to a domain, create a user account, and log into the domain. For those who are going to take the A+ exam, there are practice questions toward the end of the video. Computers on the network can be part of a workgroup or a domain. With workgroup, all computers are peers. Each computer has its own security database and a set of user accounts. To log on to any computer in the workgroup, you must have an account on that computer. A workgroup is usually used on small networks with less than 20 computers. A disadvantage of a workgroup is that every user account will have to be created on every computer. And if you use the same account on multiple computers, every time you change password, you'll have to change passwords on all computers one by one. Domains use a centralized security database or Active Directory that are stored on servers known as domain controllers, which are used to control the security and permissions for all computers on the domain. Domains allows the administrators to control computer settings to ensure inconsistency among computers. Domains can support thousands of computers and is often used in larger corporations or companies that require better security. While a client computer running Windows 10 and 11 can be part of the domain, they also have a local accounts. Remember, Windows 10 and 11 home versions do not support joining to a domain, while other versions do. Active Directory is a technology created by Microsoft that provides a variety of network services, including the following. Lightweight Directory Access Protocol, or LDAP, for querying and modifying data using directory services running over TCP/IP. LDAP uses TCP port 389. Kerberos-based authentication, which is the default computer network authentication protocol, which allows hosts to prove the identity over a non-secure network in a secure manner. Active Directory also provides single sign-on authentication. Directory Services allows you to organize and name all of the network resources, including users, groups, printers, computers, and other objects, and to manage passwords, and is a major component when discussing authorization. Directory Services is based on DNS-based naming. Active Directory provides a central location for network administration and delegation of authority. A domain controller is a Windows server that stores a replica of the account and security information of the domain and defines the domain boundaries. To make a computer running Windows Server a domain controller, it is necessary to first install the Active Directory domain services, then promote the server to a domain controller by running the Active Directory wizard. Active Directory uses multi-master replication, which means that there's no master domain controller. When an account is created or changed on one domain controller, the account is replicated to the other domain controllers. It is recommended to have more than one domain controller to provide fault tolerance. A server on the domain that is not running as a domain controller is known as a member server. To demote the domain controller to a member server, you would run the Active Directory wizard again. Within the directory, the set of objects is organized in a logical hierarchy manner so that the objects can be easily located and managed. The structure can reflect geographical or organizational boundaries, although it tends to use DNS names for structuring the topmost levels of the hierarchy. Deeper inside the directory might appear entries representing users, computers, organizational units, printers, groups of people, or anything else that represents a given tree entry or multiple entries. To help organize objects within a domain and minimize the number of domains, use organization units, commonly expressed as OUs. OUs can be used to hold users, groups, computers, and other organizational units. An organization unit can only contain objects that are located in a domain. Organizational units are usually created based on geography, function, roles, department, or teams. Organization units can also be used for management of the objects inside the organizational unit, including used to deploy group policies. An object is a distinct named set of attributes or characteristics that represent a network resource. Common objects used within Active Directory are computers, users, groups, and printers. Attributes have values that define a specific object. For example, a user can have the first name John, the last name Smith, and the login name is Jay Smith, all of which identify the user. When working with objects, administrators will use names of the objects such as the usernames. However, Active Directory objects are assigned a 128-bit unique number called the Security Identifier, or SID, sometimes referred to as the Global Unique Identifier, or GUID, to uniquely identify an object. If a user changes his or her name, you can change the name and he or she will still be able to access all objects and have all the same rights as before because they are assigned to the GUID and not the name. A user account enables a user to log on to the computer and a domain. It can be used to prove the entity of the user, authentication, which can then be used to determine what kind of access the user will have, authorization. It can be used for auditing, so that if there's a security problem and something was accessed or deleted, the user account can indicate who accessed or deleted the object. The domain user is an account that is stored on the domain controller and allows the user to gain access to resources within the domain, assuming they have been granted permissions to access those objects. When creating a domain user account, supply a first name, last name, and a user's logon name. Active Directory users' accounts have two logins. User Principal Name, or UPN, is an internet-style login name that resembles an email address. Username at domain name. To reduce confusion, it is recommended to set the UPN and the email address to the same name. SAM Account Name is a legacy login name based on the domain name slash username. The domain name is based on the NetBIOS domain name. The same account name should be less than 20 characters. Both user login names must be unique within the domain. The first account that has full access to the domain is the domain administrator. The default name of the account is domain name slash administrator. While the domain administrator user account cannot be deleted, it can be renamed. To make a user a domain administrator, you just add the user account to the domain administrators group. Like user accounts, Windows computer accounts provide a means for authentication and auditing the computer's access to a Windows network and its access to domain resources. Each Windows computer to which you want to grant access to resources must have a unique computer account. It can also be used for auditing purposes, specifying what system was used when something was accessed. Windows systems in Active Directory have a computer name, SAM account name limit of 15 characters. The names can have dashes and underscores, but cannot have spaces and other special characters. To add a computer to a domain, you open Windows Settings, System, About, Advanced System Properties. When the System dialog box opens, click the Computer Name tab and click Change. The Computer Name Domain Change dialog box allows you to add the computer to the domain and or change the computer name. To add to a domain, you click the domain options and specify the domain name. Since you already specified the name of the domain that you want to join, you just specify the name of the account on the domain and password that has the rights to add a computer to the domain. You will have to reboot the computer to finish the computer name change or adding to the domain. When you add a computer, it will be added to the computer organizational unit. You should then move it to the correct organizational unit. A group is a collection or list of user accounts or computer accounts. Different from a container, such as a domain or organizational unit, the group does not store the user or computer, it just lists them. The advantage of using groups is to simplify administration, especially when assigning rights and permissions. When assigning rights and permissions to the group, all users listed in the group receive the rights and permissions rather than grant to each user individually. When new users get hired, you add the user to the group and they will get all the rights and permissions granted to the group. Users of computers can be members of multiple groups, and in some instances, a group can be assigned to another group. In Windows Active Directory, there are two types of groups, security and distribution. The security group is used to assign rights and permissions and gain access to a network resource. It can also be used as a distribution group. A distribution group is only for non-security functions such as email distribution and cannot be assigned rights and permissions to any resources. To log in as a new user, click Other User. When you log in with a domain account to a computer that is on the domain, you don't have to add the domain name slash before the username. However, if you're logging with the domain administrator account, you will have to add the domain name slash. If this is the first time you log into Windows 10 or 11, you will take a couple minutes to finish creating the profile and setting up Windows for the user. To log in with a local account on a computer that is part of the domain, you'll have to use the computer name slash username or period slash username. The leading period specifies this computer. The administrator will be the exception. On the domain controllers, you will find the Active Directory tools are already installed. If you want to install Active Directory tools on a member server, you would use Server Manager to install the Active Directory using Server Manager Add Roles and Features Wizard. Remote Server Administration Tools, or RSAT, enables IT administrators to remotely manage roles and features in Windows servers from a computer that is running Windows 10 or 11. Tools include Active Directory Certificate Services Tools, Active Directory Domain Services Tools, DNS Server Tools, Failover Clustering Tools, File Server Tools, Group Policy Management Tools, and Hyper-V Tools. These tools are built using MMC. To install RSAT onto Windows, visit the site shown on the screen. Active Directory Users and Computers is the traditional program used to manage domain users, computers, organizational units, and groups. A newer tool is to manage domain users, computers, organization units, and groups is the Active Directory Administrative Center. It can be used to configure password setting objects and to undelete a deleted object. On a server, you can open Administrative Tools or Windows Tools and open Active Directory Users and Computers. To create an organizational unit, right-click a domain or organization unit and click New Organizational Unit. Specify the name of the organization unit and click OK. To create a user, right-click the domain or organization unit and click New User. Then specify the first and last name and the user logon names. Click Next. Specify a password and click Next. click Finish. By double-clicking a user, you open the properties of the user. The Member of tab allows you to add the user to groups. You can also open the groups to manage the members of the group. To move a group or user, right-click the group or user and click Move. Specify the root of the domain or an organization unit and click OK. Question: what does Active Directory use to store the Active Directory database? Answer: domain controller. Question: what allows you to create a user account and have that user account the ability to log on to any computer within the domain? Answer: domain account. Question: what is used to organize your resources based on function or department? Answer: organizational unit. Question: what is the maximum length of a computer name? Answer: 15. Question: what is used to simplify administration of rights and permissions? Answer: security group. For more information, visit these sites. In summary, domains use a centralized security database, Active Directory, that are stored on servers known as domain controllers, which are used to control the security permissions for all computers on the domain. A domain controller is a Windows server that stores a replica of the account and security information of the domain and defines the domain boundaries. A server that is not running as a domain controller is known as a member server. To help organize objects within a domain and minimize the number of domains, use organizational units commonly expressed as OUs. A user account enables a user to log on to a computer and domain, which can be used to prove the entity of a user, which can then be used to determine what kind of access that user will have. Authorization. The first account that has full access to domain is the domain administrator. Like user accounts, Windows computer accounts provide a means for authenticating and auditing the computer's access to a Windows network and its access to domain resources. A group is a collection or list of user accounts or computer accounts. Thank you for watching this video. The next video will be Windows Services Part 2, Understanding NTFS Permissions. Thank you.